The composition of the current threats we face is a toxic mix of strategic competitors, regional powers, weak or failed states, and non-state actors using a variety of tools in overt and subtle ways to achieve their goals. I'd like to begin with remarks on what I would describe as the Big Four: China, Russia, North Korea, and Iran, all of which pose unique threats to the United States and our partners. China's pursuit of intellectual property, sensitive research and development plans, and the U.S. person data remains a significant threat to the United States government and the private sector. Russia's approach relies on misdirection and obfuscation as it seeks to destabilize and diminish our standing in the world. Even as Russia faces a weakening economy, the Kremlin is stepping up its campaign to divide Western political and security institutions and undermine the post-World War II international order. We expect Russia will continue to wage its information war against democracies and to use social media to attempt to divide our societies. All four of these states that I have just mentioned, China, Russia, North Korea, and Iran, are advancing their cyber capabilities, which are relatively low cost and growing in potency and severity. This includes threatening both minds and machines in an expanding number of ways, such as stealing information, attempting to influence populations, or developing ways to disrupt critical infrastructures.
美国是世界的头号强国，军事实力无人能及。 如果连美国都觉得四面八方都是威胁，那么其他国家怎么办？是不是觉得危险就在家门口，日子还怎么过？我不知道美方强烈的不安全感从何而来。我想强调，世界上没有绝对的安全，一国的安全更不可能建立在别国的不安全基础之上。 中方一贯倡导树立共同综合合作可持续的新安全观。我们希望美方能够摒弃零和思维，放弃以对抗的视角来看待大国关系，顺应和平与发展的时代大潮，同中方、俄方以及国际社会一道，来共同维护国际的和平与安全。